Hi, I'm Brian Tristan Williams, and I'm here with the man himself, CEO of Raspberry Pi Trading, Eben Upton. How's today been for you?
It's been fantastic. I mean, this is our second partner event since we were able to do events again after the pandemic. Enormous amount of energy here. Just obviously, we're doing the expo this morning, so the entire building is full of interesting products and projects that people have built with Raspberry Pi.
Yeah, there certainly are interesting projects and a lot of excitement here. How is things going since the product, since the component shortage has sort of cleared up?
It's interesting. You could really see, we said it was like a light turning back on, like a light bulb turning on. You know, the end of April, suddenly this component supply situation for us eased enormously. We built about 1 million Raspberry Pis across the first 4 months of this year, but we're now into a pace of doing 1 million units each month. And we can do 1 million units each month until any remaining shortage, any remaining backlog has been resolved. It's really heartening. You know, nobody gets into this business to disappoint customers. It was obviously particularly challenging balancing the needs of our industrial customers and our enthusiast customers. It's just wonderful not to have to make those decisions anymore.
Yeah, that's great. You don't have to juggle components anymore and see who gets what and limit quantities. But you've been doing this for a long time, and your vision, speaking of your industrial customers, how has your vision changed since you started?
Obviously, you know, we came to this originally with the concept of getting young people interested in computers again. I had a computer in my house when I was a child. I learned to program. There was never one day when I decided that I wanted to be a professional engineer. I was just kind of lured into it by the availability of ambiently programmable computing in my environment. And that's really the dream for Raspberry Pi, to provide that to young people. Obviously, over the years, we've discovered that the same products that we build to appeal to young people have applicability in the adult enthusiast community and then appeal in the professional design community. Industrial and embedded applications now account for somewhere between 70 and 80% of Raspberry Pi sales. So, you know, extremely heartening, generates some of the funding that we need to continue to build new products. The really gratifying thing in the second half of 2023 has been to be able to get back to really serving that enthusiast and that educational customer base, which is still very close to our hearts.
Yeah, absolutely. So what micro did you first have growing up?
I had a BBC Micro. So I'm a 6502 BBC. I guess there are two groups of people in the UK. They tend to be of my age. There were Sinclair Atari people and there were Acorn Amiga people. And I was an Acorn Amiga person.
I wanted to be an Atari person, but my dad got me a Texas Instruments, and the rest is history.
Okay, there you are. So sort of a little slightly niche, but
yeah. Yeah, so BBC Micro never got 70, 80% of industrial market. Did you ever foresee that coming?
No, we didn't. I mean, it's interesting. I think it's a testament to the power of general purpose computing. You know, the concept, you know, what are we? We are enthusiasts, we are advocates, we are warriors for the concept of putting general purpose computing in the hands of people everywhere. I think it was interesting, though, even though we came into this with that great belief in general purpose computing, we hadn't really appreciated what the implications would be for certainly for the industrial and embedded market.
Okay, and do you find any difficulty juggling the interests of the Raspberry Pi Foundation with Raspberry Pi Trading?
Well, that's the fascinating thing. You know, certainly in terms of product design, no, absolutely not. We make some products which are targeted to that enthusiast audience. Something like a Raspberry Pi 400 is targeted very squarely at that market. And then we make products which are targeted at the industrial market. So the compute module has no real educational use case. But really the single board computer, which the core credit card sized Raspberry Pi computer, which remains the bulk of our volumes, it addresses both markets. And I can honestly say we've never had to make a design decision in that space, which is particularly focused to one market or the other. You know, I have a 6-year-old daughter, and you know, if you ask me, you know, what's the tougher environment, an oil rig or her bedroom? I'm not sure I could tell you with honesty which one is which. And it's just really heartening. Maybe there'll come a day when we need to bifurcate that product line, but it certainly hasn't come to us yet, even after 11 years in the market.
Yeah, and you just reminded me of the Raspberry Pi 400, which is a great harkening back to having everything in one case and you hook it up to your TV. That must have been an exciting product to launch for you.
It was a really exciting product. And what's interesting is that we find ourselves having to educate people that it's a computer. You know, somebody of my generation, you had to educate somebody that a computer might not look like that. We did a wonderful event. We attended Maker Faire in Hanover in August. We ran a programming workshop for Raspberry Pi Pico, which used Raspberry Pi 400 as the host machine. And you'd see people, and it was very successful, but you'd see people pick up the unit. And there was a really, really kind of beautiful feeling of people picking, looking at the unit, picking up the unit, thinking, where's the computer? And then suddenly seeing the ports along the back and realizing what they were holding in their hands. And the number of people who did that, put it down on the desk and walked straight over and bought one. You know, once people understand it, you know, it's an incredibly compelling idea that you can condense all of the logic that you need and the keyboard into one single component, one single unit.
Yes, and I'm certainly of the age where I appreciate that as well, and I'm trying to get the kids rubbed off on that as well.
That's exactly the unit that I will put in my... I'm getting to the point now where we do need to put a computer in my daughter's bedroom, and that's exactly the unit that we'll be putting in there.
Oh, big surprise. Dad gives her a Raspberry Pi.
Well, no, she's really keen to get one, actually. She's been agitating. When am I getting my Raspberry Pi? When am I getting my Raspberry Pi? My three-year-old just recognizes the logo. He's a huge fan, but he's just a fan of the logo. He's a fan of the graphic design, not so much the electronics yet.
Okay, great. We don't have a lot of kids here, but this is an amazing event, and there are some very exciting product and hardware announcements, which we will be sure to share with you in the future. Mr. Eben Upton, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you very much indeed.